Hey guys, welcome back. Okay, this will be part 14? No, 15 now. 15. 15. This is part 15. So. Tanky, tanky arm. Somebody crits at Warren's land. Crit for 2k! Instant charge. Awesome. Yeah, the Stoic is neat, but like, Comrade, like, there's no reason not to take, like, Comrade, which is just like, oh, you just.
Ooh, a treasure chest! I wonder what's inside.
Treasure chests in battles? Be careful, bonus. As your foes are defeated, any open treasure chests will be lost. Also, attacking treasure will destroy it and all of its contents. Right, I'll start getting parts from enemies now, too.
You should know, I'm scary when I get mad. I'm gonna use that item I just got on you. You'll be sorry.
Thoughts of different types of items in stock with great very special effects. The rest are unknown, so the items are actually mixed. Mixing two bomb cores, you just have to see what happens. Jesus Christ. That did a lot more damage than I thought it would.
What did you just do?
That was great!
I can combine items and use them like this. It's not that tough, really.
They have a good assigning your shoulders to do it, I bet. Alright. She's a claw, she's a targ. Okay. I'm going to keep an eye. Ooh. I honestly feel like way better finding that Albed Primer on the last little bit there, because I was starting to get, I was super paranoid I missed something from like the 11th to the 12th one. Oh, is Riku still down health? Yes, she is. That should be fun.
Watch.
Dragon scale, eh? 25 for water and ice.
So who's next?
Weapon. Don't have any water or ice for him.
Farewell.
Doesn't it reduce damage, which is fun.
No time to waste. Let's go.
Really nice music. I love the way that music sounds. Like, this is spectacular. Oh.
Back on the field!
Yeah! I want to reduce damage, but it's fine. Jerks.
Allow me. Let me break the ice.
Let me break the ice. Nice. Let's just stick with the lame puns, Lulu. Everyone was a little more sad that day. I wouldn't say that's just a Punuscule offense. Get it? Minuscule. Punuscule. Offense. Because it's a play on words. Makes it a pun. Listen. I'm not saying that you can't not enjoy my jokes, but like, you're gonna have to get used to them. He says, like, 15 episodes in. A weapon shop. First thing.
We have been expecting you, Lady Yuna. Welcome to Guado Salam.
Guado Salami.
This way, lady. This way.
Me?
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Oh, I beg your pardon. I am called Trommel Guado. I am in the direct service of our leader, the great Seymour Guado. Lord Seymour has very important business with Lady Yuna.
Business with me? Whatever could it be, I wonder?
Please, come inside the manor. All will be explained. Of course, your friends are also welcome.
Friends? Guardian?
Twist our arms, why don't you? Ah, I almost forgot.
I think you can customize weapons and armor. Ah, sweet. Okay, cool. I can do this now. Customize added ballistic gear. First, choose the gear to customize. Another weapon to customize. Then it's lost in the building. Shot in the bunch. Empty. And customize. It cannot be customized. There is also gear that cannot be customized no matter what. Now, we're just selecting the gear to customize. Let's go. Gear for pursuit charges at the top right of the screen. And then stock. So gray. Cannot be selected. Modify item. Okay, I'm just gonna...
What would you do without me?
Be missing another third of X2. Oh! Gotta help the war and once we're children lives and beyond. I won't do all the time for the good of Spira.
Care to hear about the Farplane or the Pyreflies?
Yeah, sure.
The Farplane is the place where pyreflies, born from ascending, gather. They appear in the shape of people who've died and gone to the Farplane. Quite the phenomenon. How I wish I understood it more fully. The Owlbed have a theory, you know. They say the pyreflies are just reacting to visitors' thoughts and dreams. But only the dead appear on the Farplane. No image of the living has ever been seen. It's a great mystery, but maybe the dead leave a bit of themselves in the hearts of the living. And that little bit borrows the Pyreflies' power for their paranormal performance.
It's possible.
Or maybe not, who knows. And that, as they say, is that. Care to hear?
So, fireflies.
They may be called pyreflies, but they aren't really flies, you see.
I see.
They're those lights you see whenever a fiend dies.
I see.
The little fellows are responsible for a few fantastic phenomena.
I see.
Visions of the past, spheres, fiends, these are all the pyreflies doing.
I see.
In fact, pyreflies have something to do with aeons, too. The dreams of the faith reach through the spirit of the summoner. And that which is unreal becomes real for all to see.
I see.
Or maybe not, who knows? And that, as they say, is that.
I see. So here, Mystery Spest. Thank you so much for trying the Albert contraption. You see things are despicable. I feel so relieved now. Suck this girl in the chair. She stood up.
Oh, how fare you, Sir Guardian? It seems that Maester Seymour has returned to Guado Salam.
Apparently, yeah.
He's young, but he deserves our respect.
Figured to be a little bit racist there for a second. Oh, I should save. Concerns of the Thunderplanes, please remain inside. Alright, the Thunderplanes are the next area. Oh boy. Alright, let's go over that. This is our city. Has like five houses. Ooh. S to M. So I have almost half. Kind of telling us blow apart, don't you? I suppose you think we all look the same. Not really. It's a little racist. Let us step away from the Grotto Glories and go play for Doom Tomb once in a while. Why, if they paid me enough, I can play for the Albed. As sole protectors of the Farplane, the Guado are the supreme race of Spira. We are fundamentally different from the populist humans and the hulking ones, so that's an old story. Now the Guado seek harmony with other races. 3 days ago, sweet. So you play for the Pesader Arcs. You're Titus, right? So the tournament, let's blitz some time. Those fiends really made a mess, so my teammates were badly hurt. You're supposed to be able to recruit people. I don't know how you do that, though. Like, do I just have to pay people to recruit them? I'm not entirely sure how that works. I suppose you think we look odd, don't you? That's fine. We are used to that sort of thing. They do look a little bit weird. Racing Gavin, we got to outline the joy that is Blitzball. There's the Farplane up there. Colin Jones trying to stay out of my way. I'm going to continue to run back and forth several times. Alright, let's go to the next one. Lord Seabrin instructs the Guado with humorous subjects. Thanks to him, I learned about Yevon's teachings in the history of Spira. Thou seems weary, good traveler. Would thou sit and rest thy feet for a while? Ah. Be like my speech perplexes thee. 'Tis old Guato I speak, a tongue seldom heard within Guado Salam now. Good traveler, prithee forgive us our antiquated prattling. I guess? The elders just won't give up the old tongue. They keep telling your haunts seeing you do this babbling like that to guests. We got to protect the Farplane so the dead can rest in peace. Though we go out to differ from humans in appearance, our respect for the dead is the same.
Oh!
Ooh, can I don't tell you,
these Guado merchants are shrewd. Ripping off the pilgrims that come to visit the Farplane. Listen, you watch that they don't get you, too. Me, you can trust. More than a Guado, at least. What do you say?
Let's see what weapons he's got. Oh, Water Strike, Lightning Strike. Shimmering Blade. Should pick that up and give it to her just so she has it. Yellow Targ. Yeah, I'll just give that to her too so she has something. I pick up all the yellow stuff here if I wanted to. Yeah, I'm looking at stuff with Water Strike. Oof, Jesus, they're way charging way more than he does. I'm going to lightning planes, I'll probably need and all the yellow protective crap I'll need I can get my hands on.
don't like the smell of this one, eh?
These are the past leaders of the Guado. Hmm.
They all look the same.
Mr. Seymour doesn't look like them, though.
Don't you know? The last leader, Maester Jiskel, wed a human woman. She was Seymour's mother.
Hmm. Oh. That's interesting.
Stay close to Yuna.
I wonder what smells so nice.
Kimari not like Mr. Seymour.
Don't buy me.
Why does he want to see me?
This way, please.
Chomel. Let's go see what this is.
I will go inform Lord Seymour. Please wait here.
Pretty good spread of food.
I get the feeling he called us up here for more than just dinner.
And then, one of the main villains of the game politely had dinner and did nothing else suspicious.
Stay on your guard.
Why? This guy is just a priest, right?
Those with power use that power. Maesters have power.
Wait. You sure you don't have something against Yevon?
I lived a long time in Xanarkand.
Ah.
There's no temple here in Guadasalam, see? Summoners usually just pass through on their way elsewhere. What?
I didn't even ask a question and you're explaining things.
You'd rather I say nothing, then?
No. Maybe you finally believe I don't know anything about Spira. And maybe that means you believe me about Xanarkand, too?
Well, there are many things I do not know. Your Xanarkand is one of those things. I suppose I can't say what I think, either way. Still, be careful. You shouldn't tell other people.
Yeah, I know.
This is good!
Kimari, speak no more.
What could it be? Oh.
Poor Yuna. That's bright.
Truly, it is good to have guests again. Since Lord Jiskel passed away, these halls have been too quiet.
The death of Lord Jiskel was a great loss for all of Spira.
Was this Maester Jiskel really such a great guy?
He brought the teachings of Yevon to the Guado. He was truly a great man.
Truly a loss for us all. But now a new leader, Lord Seymour, has come before us. Lord Seymour is the child of a Guado and a human. He will be the tie that binds our two races together. But that is not all, I think. Lord Seymour, he will surely become the shining star that lights the way for all the peoples of Spira.
That is enough trouble. Must I always endure such praise? Welcome!
You wanted to see me?
Please, make yourselves at home. There's no rush.
Please keep this short. Yuna must rush.
Pardon me. It has been a long time since I had guests.
Dude,
Lady Yuna, shot, yeah. This way. Sphere is a reconstruction created from the thoughts of the dead that wander the far.
Xanarkand?
Correct. Xanarkand, as it looked 1,000 years ago.
Huh.
And wondrous Machina City, Xanarkand. She once lived in this metropolis.
She who? Lady Unalesca!
She was the first person to defeat Sin and save the world from its ravages. And you have inherited her name.
It was my father who named me.
Lord Braska was entrusting you with a great task. He wanted you to face Sin as Lady Unalesca did. However, Lady Unalesca did not save the world alone. To defeat the undefeatable Sin, it took an unbreakable bond of love, of the kind that binds two hearts for eternity.
Did you just propose to her? Something to drink.
Wow, your face is beet red.
You okay?
He asked me to marry him.
You serious? Hey.
You know what Yuna must do.
Of course. Lady Yuna. No, all summoners are charged with bringing peace to Spirit. But this means more than just defeating Sin. She must ease the suffering of all Spirit. She must be a leader for the people. I proposed to Lady Yuna as a maester of Yevon.
Spirit is no playhouse. A moment's diversion may amuse an audience, but it changes nothing.
Even so, the actors must play their parts. There's no need to answer right away. Please, think it over.
We will do so then. We leave.
Lady Yuna, I await your favorable reply. Why are you still here, sir? I beg your pardon. We Guado are keen to the scent of the Farplane.
So I do believe Orin should be dead. Well, Yuna wants to enter. She wants to get all up in those private chambers. Shifty eyes.
Yuna, the High Summoner's daughter. Seymour, the leader of the Guado. Married in the name of Yevon. Overcoming the barriers of race. It would give Spira something cheery to talk about for a change.
Sounds just like a passing daydream, like Auron says.
Come on, let's just get on with the pilgrimage. I mean, marriage?
Jealous?
What? No way. We gotta defeat Sin. Romance can wait.
You sure picked a fine time to lay this one on us.
Maybe it is a fine time.
You serious?
If my getting married would help Spira? If it would make people happy, if I could do that for people, maybe I should do what I can. I never imagined doing anything like this. But I won't answer till I know what's right.
Seriously?
You could always just quit your pilgrimage and get married.
I will. Go on. I'm sure that Lord Seymour will understand.
I guess so.
I am a summoner. I must fight and defeat Sin.
Like Braska before you.
I had to stop myself from shouting.
What's there to think about?
I'm going to the Farplane. I'm going to see my father and think on this.
Go on. We'll be right behind you.
I wondered why none of the others ever asked Yuna. Do you love Seymour? Do you even like him?
I mean, you should know better than anybody that she probably just doesn't like him. Humans, a summoner and her guardians. Okay. Whatever. Racist. Remember, the Farplane is sacrosanct. Proper conduct, please. Farplane is sink or swim.
Question. About this Farplane. When somebody dies, a summoner sends them to the Farplane, right? So their souls, or whatever they are, they go to the Farplane, right? But that's the Farplane we're going to, right? And Yuna's old man's there too? Do dead people live there or something?
Spooky.
Spooky. You thinking those funny thoughts again, yeah? You'll see once we get there.
Aren't you coming?
I do not belong there.
You're scared.
Searching the past to find the future. This is all that is there. I need it not. You'd better be going.
You're not really going to see the dead. More like your memories of them. People think of their relatives, and the Pyreflies react to them. They take on the form of the dead person. An illusion, nothing else. Well, Have fun.
What? You're not going either, Riku?
I keep my memories inside.
Huh?
Memories are nice, but that's all they are. See you later.
You're still here?
Alright, fine. I'll go. Jeez. Chapu.
What the?
Wow, what? Well, it's way bigger on the inside. A little
spooky. Farplane was cool, but I couldn't stop thinking about Yuna. Her parents, they looked so happy together, but it got me worried that maybe seeing them would make Yuna really consider Seymour's proposal.
Yeah.
Why don't you try calling someone? All you have to do is think about them.
Yo, Chapu! Meant to come see you earlier, yeah? Sorry. I know you won't hold it against me. I gave up the game. I'm a guardian from here on, you know? This guy looks a lot like you. Showed up. Traveling with him, I thought maybe you were still alive somewhere, yeah? But then again, here you are on a far plane. Guess your place is here. So, how you been? Oh, that guy I just told you about? I gave him a sword. He likes it.
Huh? Wow. So, Yuna?
I've decided.
Really? That's good.
I remember when I was only 7 years old in Bavel that day. My father had defeated Sin. And the whole town was out in the streets. Everyone was laughing. They all seemed so happy. If I defeated Sin, that would make everyone happy, wouldn't it? I must do what everyone wants, not just what I want.
Let's go back. You gotta tell Seymour.
Before that, call Sir Jet. Give it a try.
Huh?
Don't worry. He won't come.
Trying not to think about my old man made me think about him, of course.
See, told you.
He isn't here because he's not dead. He's Sin.
That means he's alive, you know.
What if my old man really is Sin? Hmm. What would I say to Yuna? Heck, to everybody in Spira. Wait, why should I have to apologize for him anyway? I'd rather never see him again.
What makes you hate him so?
Because he was an alcoholic, abusive prick.
It was his fault that me and my mother... Mom? It's her.
She's very pretty.
But... wait... no one ever performed the sending for her.
She must have accepted death
while she was still alive.
Whoa there. That's my mother you're talking about.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I think I just figured something out.
What?
Why I hate my old man.
Oh.
See, so I told him what I thought of him right there.
What, really? Of
course.
I suppose, but...
Mommy!
Just a sec, dear.
Whenever my old man was around, my mother wouldn't even look at me. Maybe that's when I started to resent him, even hate him. When he left us, Mom just lost her energy.
Is she all right?
Why should you care?
If she dies, I wouldn't know what to do.
Don't say Mom is gonna die.
I apologize.
The old lady next door told me, when a lovebird dies, the one left behind, it just gives up living so it can join its mate. It was just like that. I hated my old man even more. But really, my old man...
Mommy!
Just a sec, dear.
Go to him. He'll cry if you don't.
Oh, man. I must sound so stupid.
I don't think so.
How embarrassing.
Well, need some more time.
No. I'm ready.
Did I miss something?
She still has an apple.
Thanks for waiting. I'll go give my answer to Maester Seymour.
A resounding fuck no.
Lord Driscoll! Oh, Lord Driscoll!
He does not belong here.
Why?
Yuna, send him.
Lord Driscoll.
He is Lord Driscoll no more. Send him now.
What's going on with Orin?
Talk later. We leave now.
What was that just now? That really Lord Driscoll?
I don't understand how a man like Lord Driscoll can die and not be sent.
I would think that he was sent once, but he stayed on Spira. Something, a powerful emotion, could have bound him to this world. Such things happen.
That's against the rules, isn't it?
It means he died an unclean death.
Alright, well, I guess we're gonna have a chit-chat with Seymour. Seymour.
I will go. Meet with Maester Seymour.
Yuna! Driscoll is the Guado's problem, not yours.
What?
So, Lulu, what do you think about Yuna getting married?
As long as the pilgrimage continues, either way's fine.
That's it? What if she doesn't even like the guy? Is that okay?
People marry for many reasons.
What's that mean?
I haven't talked a lot in the past, like, 20 minutes.
Doesn't require love, you know? Defeat sin and bring joy to the people of Spira.
Get married and bring joy to the people of Spira. For Yuna, they're just two ways down the same road. All you need is determination. If you have that, you don't need love.
I don't know. I just don't get it.
Titus, you are young. Do not worry about such things.
For a while there, I was a little worried about what was gonna happen, yeah?
Yeah.
We leave as soon as Yuna returns. I trust you'll be ready.
Hopefully.
Listen, if Yuna gets married, then I...
What? That again?
Yes. If she is to marry, I would want her to marry for love.
See?
But if Yuna said she wanted to marry the one she loves, I would have to object.
Huh? You're not making much sense.
I know.
No, it makes sense. I can agree with her on that one. She'd want her to marry for... She wants her to finish her pilgrimage because it's for the good of everybody. But marrying for love would only be good for Yuna.
We have to go through the Thunder Plains next, you know?
She sounds extremely uneasy about that. Mario around here somewhere? I didn't see him. Did he go in with her? Am I blind? Am I missing the big blue cat? Oop.
Guado potion's good. Buy some before leaving.
There he is. More. Bye. Same shit as before.
Guado potion.
So, now what?
My, was the Lady Summoner not with you?
No, she's at Seymour's place.
That's Maester Seymour, or Lord Seymour.
Oh, I'll be careful. Sorry.
That's all right. Oh, Maester Seymour left Guado Salam a short while ago.
You serious?
I believe he went to the temple in Makalania. Maester Seymour is also the High Priest of that temple.
Whoa! I gotta tell the others!
Good, they all gathered together already. Jinkies, gang!
Lord Jiskel, please, tell me. What can I do to help?
Yuna, let's go!
What the hell did he drop, though? To the Thunder Plains. Hopefully there's a save point there. If not, we'll come back in.
Seymour went to Macarena Temple.
Macalania Temple.
Macarena.
What I don't get is... Why would the Lord Maester head off without a peep to anyone?
Maybe he wasn't expecting Yuna's answer so soon.
Ah, that's probably it.
Yuna, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
You're a poor liar.
It's true, it's nothing. Come on, let's go.
You're a poor liar. I could just tell that they were just bold-faced. You suck at lying, lady. Toads don't try it. Thunder Plains. To Macalina. The woods.
Oh no! We're here!
are we supposed to cross that?
By running.
See the lightning rod towers? The lightning is drawn to them. Hopefully.
Hopefully.
We head north, not too near and not too far from the towers, yeah?
Meaning we should avoid wide open areas.
I think I forgot something in Guado Salam.
Nice knowing you.
Okay, okay, I'll go.
Construct tires and thunder planes. Keep moving. And the tires serve me really strict. Seek shelter under them. Be dangerous. Good luck on your journey. Dodge it. I got this chest over here. Steal from the elemental. Electro mobile.
Go with the flow.
All lightning based, it seems. Strong musk. Water equipment or anything. Got a steel sphere for you guys. Prep on. Fucking Pilver Girl just realized I'm on that level 2. Fuck. Unless I go over there and get that point of agility, I guess. God damn it. Didn't look at it very closely. Me about that. Alright, save. So much story stuff in this last segment. Holy crap. Really didn't really have to say much about anything. Anyways, we'll call this a good time to stop, so thank you guys for watching. If you guys saw, please like, please comment, please subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.